Hi, my name is Madison. This is Tanner, and this is Miles. We're students at the JB Speed School of Engineering.
Today, we're going to give you a quick tour of JB Speed. Speed School goes well beyond the classroom.
From our co-op program to our research opportunities and our clubs, you'll definitely find something you're interested in. With that, we need to get started. We have a lot to cover.
This is Community Park, otherwise known as CP. This is where the engineering live and learning community is. So if you choose to live here, you'll be living with only engineering students. So this is housed on the second and third floor of CP. I lived here my freshman year and I really, really liked it. I really enjoyed having engineers on the floor as well as a sense of community.
This is our main building of JB Speed School of Engineering. On the top floor, we house industrial engineering, which is the engineering behind efficiencies. On the second floor, we house our main admissions for Speed School of Engineering. The first floor houses our fundamental of engineering department, where you'll take all your calc classes. It also houses our REACH tutoring room. On the bottom level of this building, we house our advisors. Once you are admitted into Speed School of Engineering, you are given one advisor your entire time here at U of L.
If you're going to be an electrical engineer or a civil engineer, you'll spend a lot of time in WS Speed. On the second floor of this building is the electrical engineering department, housing both our faculty members as well as different laboratories. They work on anything from networking systems to automation. On the first floor in the basement, we have the civil engineering department. They also have labs on this side of campus, from concrete explosion to high quality driving simulation.
This is Sackett Hall. If you're thinking about being a mechanical engineer, this is probably where you'll spend the most of your time. A lot of your classrooms will be housed on the first and second floor, as well as your labs. So Sackett has one large concrete lab room. It has to be concrete so we can't break anything. And this is also used as a study hall outside of class hours. So when there isn't a lab in there, you can go in there and work on your different projects.
If 3D printing is what you like, the Henry Vogt building is for you. In this building, we have the AMIST core facility. AMIST stands for the Additive Manufacturing Institute of Science and Technology. This institute focuses all of our 3D printing research. Many of our mechanical students choose to go to the AMIST core facility for both research and co-op work.
This is the Duthie Center for Engineering. It houses our computer science and engineering department. Upstairs, we have designated labs just for our computer engineers. So if you're interested in any software coding, this is definitely the discipline for you. This building also houses our co-op office. A co-op is where our students go out into industry and actually work for companies. The co-op office helps you navigate the entire process.
In Ernst, the chemical engineering department is housed. This is where you'll end up taking your calc exams, as well as a couple of your general chemistry classes. So here a lot of classes and different labs are housed, as well as one for the Conn Center for Renewable Energy.
As a bioengineer, I've spent much of my time in Lutz Hall. On the fourth floor of this building, we have all of our departmental resources. This building also houses many of our different research labs, teaching us anything from biomaterials research to biomechanics studies.
You'll find a lot of labs at the Shumaker Research Building, one of which is the Micro Nanotechnology Center. It's actually a clean room because the technology that they make in there is so small that dust particles can actually disrupt the research. The robotics research lab is also housed here. Here they develop technology for robots to interact with humans. So some of the things they're working on is making robots that can help children with autism recognize different facial expressions and emotions.
This is the Belknap Academic Building, also known as BAB. This is our newest building here on campus. We also have our Engineering 110 course in this building, which is the first semester course that all of our freshmen go through. And the idea behind this course is to give students an idea of what types of careers they can pursue based on the discipline they're in.
Here at Speed School, we prioritize hands-on work. The engineering garage is solely designed for that aspect. Here, you will spend your fundamental courses focusing on mixing the engineering disciplines in order to learn how to build collectively as a team. The engineering garage also serves as a space for many of our clubs and organizations, the competitive ones especially.
Here is the AMIST training facility. So here at this AMIST location, we have a lot of different 3D printers that help with additive manufacturing research. So companies will come to us with new design ideas for an additive manufacturing product, and we produce it using less material and making it cheaper for the company before they start putting it on their line. That was a quick look at Speed School. If you want the full experience, come for an in-person tour. We hope to see you here.